I'll start by going here and searching for RX Java, and I will be downloading this jar file. Next, I'll go ahead and create a new project. And I'll drop the downloaded jar file over here and right click and properties and Java build path and libraries and add jar, and we're going to be adding this guy. And I'll go ahead and create a new class. That's going to be in this package. And we'll have another class that will implement observer, and that's going to be the RX one. And by doing that, we're going to add these three methods. And the simple demo is going to be the driver, so it's going to have a main method. And here we will have this list. And I will obtain an observable string by doing observable.from and pass it this list. So using the from method, we can create observable from various structures in Java, and we will return an observable that emits each item in the source. So it will emit each one of those items. And the last thing that I will be doing here is doing observable string dot subscribe and create a new instance of simple observer. Now this implements methods to handle the items the observable emits and any error or completion notification it issues. So we are talking about these three methods. Let's change this to string and do a println statement here. So this method provides the observer with a new item to observe, and the observable may call this method zero or more times, and the observable will not call this method again after it calls either the uncompleted or the onError methods. And here, let me just put a println statement indicating that there was an error. And what this method does is it notifies the observer that the observable has experienced an error condition. And let me also put a println statement here. And this method notifies the observer that the observable has finished sending push-based notifications, and the observable will not call this method if it calls the onError method. So essentially, this observer provides a mechanism for receiving push-based notifications, and after an observer calls an observable subscribe method, the observable calls the observer's observer.unnext method. In order to provide notifications. Next, let's go ahead and test run this application. So here we go. The three values here were printed by this onNext method, and then the onCompleted method was triggered, and it printed out this statement.